गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट शूट एपिकल मेरिस्टेम एंड द शूट एपिक्स हैज़ बीन एक्सटेंसिवली स्टडीड बाय अ नंबर ऑफ वर्कर्स एंड मैनी थ्योरीज हैव बीन प्रपोज्ड सच एज एपिकल सेल थ्योरी, हिस्टोजन थ्योरी, ट्यूनिका कॉर्पस थ्योरी, मेंटल कोर कॉन्सेप्ट and concept of French school and at last concept of Newman. First of all, we will discuss about the introduction of shoot apical meristem. The term shoot is a collective term for the stem and its appendages, and the terminal part of the shoot with leaf primordia is known as shoot apex. That means area above the base of youngest leaf. The apical meristem of shoot is organized during the development of embryo in seed plants. The shoot apical meristem is the area of primary organization of shoot in which the processes of growth take place, and these cannot be limited to a point. The apical meristem may be dome-like, conical, flat, or even concave. The cells of this area are thin-walled with dense cytoplasm and lack vacuoles. As we discuss that there are many theories regarding the shoot apex, first of all, there is apical cell theory. A single apical cell occurs in many plants, such as in algae, bryophytes, and in case of bryophytes like Jungermanniales, Anthocerotales, and Pteridophytes, or in the most of ferns like Selaginella. It was considered that by its activity, the entire plant body is formed. The concept of single apical cell dividing in a regular or predictable manner and giving rise to all other cells of these plants was accepted by many botanists, and this idea was further taken by or proposed by Hofmeister, and he published the first description about the apical meristem of angiosperm. And he reported a unique initial cell in case of Zostera marina, and this cell being visible in early stages of the development and dividing like the single apical cell of Equisetum. Hofmeister's apical cell theory held that there was no fundamental differences in the mode of origin of apical tissue between vascular cryptogams and phanerogam, because it supposed that the cell could be traced to the divisions of a single apical cell. And Hofmeister's apical theory received strong support from Pringsim, Nigelli, and other co-workers, and the gymnosperms received considerable attention because of their phylogenetic position between vascular cryptogams and angiosperm, and over the interpretation of their complex apexes. And many workers reported a single tetrahedral or prismatic apical cells in gymnosperms apexes. And Strasburger and Groom noticed or could see no evidence for single apical cells. And angiosperms believed to have usually three cutting faces, but sometimes only two cutting faces, that is apical initial cells. The presence of complex growing apexes in the higher plants cannot be explained by this theory. And further investigation stated that different parts of plant body arises independently. And in the diagram for apical cell theory, we can see a single apical cell and surrounding the daughter cells, and from this apical cell the whole plant body that arises. And this was our first theory, that is apical cell theory, and second is histogen theory. Hansteen, working mostly with angiosperm, proposed this theory. His ideas were based after studies of 46 angiosperm genera, and some of these genera are Populus, Platanus, Aesculus, Sambucus, and Robinia. And this theory explained that the shoot apex in angiosperm consists of a central core, irregularly arranged cells called pleurome, covered by a variable number of mantle-like layers with each other, being derived from distinct group of initials called histogens or tissue formers or tissue builders. And these enveloping layers of the stem differentiated into histogens. Outermost uniseriate dermatogen layer followed by the middle periblum, that is isodimetric cells lying between the dermatogen and pleurome, and the inner massive central core of pleurome consisting of cells extended in longitudinal direction. These layers were designated as the histogens by Hansteen. Regarding histogenesis, he proposed that dermatogen cells divide anticlinally to develop into a single layered epidermis, and the periblum forms the cortex, and the inner pleurome giving rise to massive central cylinders consisting of primary vascular tissue and ground tissue like pith, pithrace, and pericycle. As regard the organization of shoot apex in angiosperm, this theory has been found to be inadequate mainly for two reasons. Because shoot apexes hardly show any distinction between periblum, pleurome in apical parts of many angiosperm and gymnosperm. And second is, it is not possible to assign origin of different area from the sharply defined histogens. And here is diagram for histogen theory. There are three layers of histogens, as we discussed: dermatogen, periblum, and pleurome. And our next theory is tunica corpus theory. Tunica corpus theory, as this theory was given by Summit, and there are only two tissue zones in this theory, that is inner corpus or central tissue, and outer is the tunica. And there are various diagrams for tunica corpus theory, and in these diagrams we can see clearly the outer layer, which Summit regarded as outer covering, and that is known as tunica, and the inner layer, that is corpus. The shoot apex, according to this theory, consisting of these two layers. And our next theory is mantle core concept. This concept was put forward by Popham and Chan in 1950. They used the term mantle for the outer dome-shaped enveloping layer and the core for central area. The term tunica is reserved strictly for the outer layers showing only anticlinal division, whereas mantle includes all the layers dividing anticlinally as well as the cells of the inner tunica layer towards the corpus showing periclinal division. This is the difference between mantle and tunica. The cells included in the core divide in all the planes, and the theory is just substitute for tunica and corpus theories. Tunica is regarded for the outer covering, and this is the diagram for a mantle core concept. Our outer, as we discussed, that the outer layer, that is mantle, Here are the cells with anticlinear division or paraclinear divisions, and the inner is the core, and this was our mental core concept as studied by Popham and Chan. And our next theory is the concept of French school. This theory was studied by Plantfort, Buvet, and Amifort, and there is donation scheme for angiosperms and also for the gymnosperms, and there are again three areas in apical meristem of shoot. First is peripheral active zone, or that is also known as anioincial, and second is meristem D antennae or waiting meristem, and third one is the pith meristem. The first zone or area that is peripheral active zone give rise to tissue in the outer or peripheral areas of stem, epidermis, cortex and endodermis. And second, that is waiting meristem. It is active only during the formation of inflorescence or terminal flowering. And third is pith meristem. And this meristem give rise to vascular areas and pith. And here is the diagram for these three areas, as shown in the diagram, and the areas as designated in French language: meristem D antennae and new initial meristem medullaris. But we translated it into our Indian language. That is, first one is peripheral active zone. Second is waiting meristem and third is pith meristem. So again, outer one, middle one and inner one. So these were three areas according to the concept of French school. And next is concept of Newman. Newman recognized three types of shoot apexes. First is monoplex. Second is simplex and third is duplex. First of all, we will discuss about the monoplex. The shoot apex may have one or more cells that divides by walls which are parallel to the inclined stem walls. And this is found in ferns and alleys, as shown in the diagram. Second is simplex, and in this category there are one or more initial cells, as shown in the diagram, and arranged in a single layer of shoot apex, and these cells divide anticlinal and periclinal means, and these are found in gymnosperms. And our third category is duplex. The shoot apex consists of two successive layers of initials, and the outer layer divides in anticlinal manner and the inner one in both anticlinal and periclinal, and this is found in angiosperms. And this was all about our today's topic, and this was shoot apical meristem. Thank you.